कर रहे हैं उसके बाद स्टार्ट हो जाएगा, ठीक है? ऊपर लाइव दिखेगा,
दिखा
रहे हैं। गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स,
गुड आफ्टरनून सर,
या विश यू वार्म वेलकम टू वन इनोवेटिव सीरीज ऑफ लर्निंग। टुडे वी आर डूइंग द फाइनेंशियल कोचिंग फॉर इन्वेस्टर। टिल नाउ माय मोस्ट ऑफ द वीडियो आर फोकस्ड टू द intermediaries, basically those who are working into financial service sector as a independent financial advisor or relationship manager. But today I have decided to interact and communicate to the directly investors, and by this way we can educate the need of the qualified and certified financial planner for their financial planning or wealth management or portfolio planning. So definitely today we are doing first video of financial coaching, okay? And financial coaching or financial planning is a very wide subject. So definitely this video will be only for 15 minutes today, and definitely maybe once in a every day or maybe at least 2 to 3 videos every week I'll upload. So I'll be naming the video 1, video 2, video 3. So those who are investors, okay, or maybe the independent advisors basically want to become a certified financial planner, they can understand the need of learning the financial planning, and then they can join the our classroom or video lectures program. Even investor can contact directly to me, okay? So we can customize the financial planning, financial coaching session in a group of one family or maybe multiple family, and that's how we can educate you to take a informed decision. Kyunki aaj ki date mein why financial coaching आ रहा है वहां पे परफेक्ट। सो व्हाई नीड ऑफ फाइनेंशियल कोचिंग, आपको थोड़ा क्लोज आना है तो क्लोज भी आ सकती है। तो क्यों जरूरत फाइनेंशियल कोचिंग की है एक इन्वेस्टर को, क्योंकि अनफॉर्चुनेटली हमारे कंट्री में जो फाइनेंशियल प्रोडक्ट या नॉन फाइनेंशियल प्रोडक्ट है, जैसे हम नॉन फाइनेंशियल प्रोडक्ट को कहते हैं रियल एस्टेट और मे बी अ ज्वेलरी और मे बी अ फाइनेंशियल प्रोडक्ट लाइक म्यूचुअल फंड, इंश्योरेंस एटसेट्रा, तो वहां पे जो मॉडल हमारा है, या इवन व्हेन यू बाय द शेयर, आप ब्रोकर के थ्रू बाय करते हैं, तो मॉडल हमारा ऐसा बना हुआ है कि जब वो आप उसे कुछ खरीदते हैं तभी उसको कुछ अर्निंग होती है। तो कहीं ना कहीं क्या होता है कि यहाँ पे जो रिलेशनशिप है वो बायर एंड सेलर की है, कि भाई आप, मैं आपके पास आता हूं एज ए आप इन्वेस्टर है और मैं इंटरमीडिएटरी हूं और आप कुछ मुझसे खरीदते हैं, या आप मेरे पास मेरी बैंक में आते हैं, मैं कॉर्पोरेट प्राइवेट सेक्टर बैंक या पीएसयू बैंक की बात करता हूं, जहां पे क्लाइंट बैंकिंग रिलेशनशिप के लिए कुछ ना कुछ रीजन से आएंगे। तो कहीं ना कहीं हो सकता है कि क्लाइंट की नीड, इन्वेस्टर की नीड कुछ डिफरेंट है, बट हो सकता है उनको कोई और प्रोडक्ट दी जाएगी बिकॉज ऑफ दी हायर कमीशन। तो सबसे बड़ा नीड इसलिए फाइनेंशियल कोचिंग है, इन्वेस्टर को क्यों फाइनेंशियल कोचिंग करना चाहिए, क्योंकि मार्केट में जो रिलेशनशिप जो है, जिसको हम कहते हैं इंटरमीडिएटरीज, रिलेशनशिप मैनेजर और प्राइवेट सेक्टर बैंक और पीएसयू बैंक्स, और यू कैन से एजेंट्स, इंडिपेंडेंट एजेंट्स जो रहते हैं, जिसको हम कहते हैं म्यूचुअल फंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर, इंश्योरेंस डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर, तो कहीं ना कहीं उनकी इनकम, आप जब उनसे कुछ प्रोडक्ट लेते हैं या सर्विस लेते हैं तभी होती है। आप रियल एस्टेट बाय करते हैं तो रियल एस्टेट एजेंट को खरीदना, रियल एस्टेट एजेंट को इनकम होगी, तो कहीं ना कहीं आप रियल एस्टेट एजेंट के पास जाएंगे और बोलेंगे मेरे पास 50 लाख है, मुझे क्या करना चाहिए, तो रियल एस्टेट एजेंट आपको क्या बताएगा, डेफिनेटली वही बताएगा आपको प्रॉपर्टी बाय करनी चाहिए। क्यों? क्योंकि वो रियल एस्टेट एजेंट है, ही इज नॉट अ फाइनेंशियल कोच और फाइनेंशियल प्लानर, ही इज अ एजेंट। सो उसका एक ही ऑब्जेक्टिव है कि आपके पास 50 लाख है, 1 करोड़ है, 5 करोड़ है, मैं प्रॉपर्टी का डीलर हूं, मैं आपको प्रॉपर्टी दिखाऊंगा। हो सकता है कि आपके पास जो 50 लाख है वो आप नेक्स्ट मंथ कुछ ऑब्जेक्टिव के लिए यूज करना चाहते हैं, एंड देन फॉर 1 मंथ हाउ कैन यू बाय द प्रॉपर्टी, बट इवन दो ही विल शो यू प्रॉपर्टी एंड से दैट आफ्टर 1 मंथ यू कैन टेक अ लोन अगेंस्ट दिस प्रॉपर्टी, ओके? आप इंश्योरेंस एजेंट के पास जाएंगे, लाइफ इंश्योरेंस एजेंट की मैं बात करता हूं, तो वो आपको बताएगा हमेशा कि हर एक गोल के लिए क्या लेना चाहिए, लाइफ इंश्योरेंस लेना चाहिए। आप शेयर ब्रोकर के पास जाएंगे तो हर एक गोल के लिए या हर एक इन्वेस्टमेंट के लिए आपको कौन सा लेना चाहिए, तो कि डायरेक्ट शेयर्स लेना चाहिए। तो मेन प्रॉब्लम यह है कि इन आवर कंट्री द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मॉडल वेयर दे अर्न द मनी, दे अर्न द इनकम, और यू कैन से कमीशन व्हेन यू बाय द some products. And definitely, if I work into the private sector bank as a relationship manager, okay, and I have given a target, okay, suppose my annual salary is, example, 10 lakh rupees per annum, and I have given target to generate the 50 lakh rupees income to bank to satisfy the my cost of salary. So when I have to generate the 50 lakh rupees commission or income for a bank, I have to sell a minimum 5 crore rupees product. So if average commission is 10% for a bank earning, whether bank you buy from the bank or relationship manager sells the life insurance product, mutual fund product, or alternative investment product, or maybe any other products. So average commission is 10%, then 5 crore rupees product he sells, or average 50 lakh rupees product he sells every month to you, to their clients, then he'll be able to earn the 5 lakh rupees commission, okay, and then he'll be able to satisfy the his salary. So problem is that when the distribution model, the income come from the commission, and as you know that when we are an investor, most of the time when we go to a vegetable vendor and when we have to buy a 1 kg potato, we negotiate, we check the quality, but unfortunately the financial products are the intangible product, and you may not able to understand the features, advantage, benefit or limitations of the product. So what is the important today? I can say that every day if you go to a various newspaper or go to online portal, you find that most of the customer complain about the mis-selling, okay, where the bank relationship manager missold the product, okay, instead of giving the fixed deposit, the client requirement was the fixed deposit, but it was sold the life insurance plan as a fixed deposit, or mutual fund product as a fixed deposit, or real estate agent sold some land, okay, or maybe some other products. So now we can't every time responsible seller for that mis-selling. The equally responsible for whatever happening to you is you also, buyer also, investor also. So it is your duty that when you earn the income, so when I as an investor earn the income, so when I as an investor earn the income, so there is a family, there is an income is there, we can say take home income after taxes. Suppose there is a 100,000 income is there, it is a duty of client how he can divide this income. Suppose if I say that 70,000 is the monthly expense and 30,000 client wants to invest to save the taxes or achieve their financial goal like retirement, children higher education, or going for vacation, or buying some aspirational product, etc. So now it is second most important is that saving 30,000 rupees in every month. So it is his duty to learn. His duty to learn that how he can save 30,000 rupees in a suitable products, okay, with help of the qualified and certified financial planner, okay, or qualified person who can provide the quality advisory. And if you find that you don't know who is the qualified person, okay, then it is your duty to learn first, okay. And when you learn the basics of the financial planning or wealth management or portfolio planning, you will be able to take a conscious call and you will be able to identify the who is the right advisor and who is not right advisor, or who is a suitable advisor. So now you save 30,000 rupees per month, so you are saving 360,000 per annum. And suppose if you save, example, 360,000 per annum incremented average by 10% per annum, because it is expected that your salary will increase 10-15% per annum, or income will increase. And now suppose if you are investing 3.6 lakh per annum increase by 10% for next 20-30 years for your life goal, or maybe to save the taxes, or to create a wealth for your family, etc. So if you do not invest into the right product, then chances that you may lose your capital. Today we know that 90% investor, those who are investing in direct equity, they likely to lose their capital part or full, because they do mostly intraday, future and option, double trading or short term trading, because they feel that wealth can be created overnight. So there are a lot of myth is there. Or maybe your broker who can earn only when you trade more. So broker will always suggest to trade more frequently into various you can say intraday or future and options, etc. So you churn more and they earn the more brokerage. So it is your duty okay, what you should do. So for that, if you basically enroll, okay, with the, there are two options for you as an investor. One, you can identify qualified and certified financial planner, okay, and you can get his consultation. Or if you find that it is not possible, or you can edit, you can come with us, with Keyur Shah. Okay, I am a CFP coach, full time certified financial planner coach. With my guidance, in last 7 years, almost 325 plus participants have successfully completed. So you can join with me, okay, into one-to-one financial planning or one-to-one financial coaching, or maybe we can have a group of 5 or 10 family coaching, okay. And that's how you understand the nitty-gritty of investment. You understand the what are the need of your life, what are the aspiration of life. Let first we complete the needs of the life, like retirement planning, children, higher education, and then you can plan for aspiration like vacation goal, etc. Today, unfortunately, in morning I shared one message that there is a one person who is the age of 68 year. Okay, he was working as a fake ticket checker in Andheri, okay, to earn the extra money at age of 68 because he lost the job. Suppose that person, uske pass, samjho apna retirement ka corpus hota, to aaj wo usko wo karne ki zarurat nahi padti. To kahin na kahin yahan pe जब आप एक क्वालिफाइड सर्टिफाइड फाइनेंशियल कोच के पास जाते हैं, तो आपको वो इमोशनल, टुडे हमारे काफी सारे डिसीजन जो रहते हैं वो मोर इमोशनल एंड लेस लॉजिकल होते हैं. तो यू विल हैव अ लेस इमोशनल, यू विल लर्न हाउ टू डू लेस इमोशनल एंड मोर लॉजिकल डिसीजन. यू विल एबल टू टेक अ हाउ आई कैन क्रिएट अ एसेट्स विच इज द a productive asset. Productive asset means which can generate the cash flow, because there are two kind of assets. Where one asset, you may be emotionally satisfied that I have a two house, I have a one land, commercial property, but cash flow may be a very small, okay, and you may not able to sell this asset whenever you require, because the asset cannot be sold in part, or it is difficult to sell in a short time. So you must have a minimum 50-60% in a financial asset also, so which could be a suitable financial asset. So that's how, as I said, the journey is very long of financial coaching for the investor. So this is the first introductory video. So let me conclude that I am sure that this is a technical video. You may not like, there is no entertainment, is there only the education is there to ensure that you take a logical and informed decision for your investment and financial planning, so which will help you to take a live the life during the post retirement, or you can able to achieve your children's education and marriage goal, and you can enjoy life peacefully. So today, let me conclude. Thank you very much for watching the video.